YouTube. Now that you have some astrophotography equipment, let's review how we set up our gear. This next series I'm calling Some Assembly Required. Yeah, you've seen it on many Christmas Eve boxes. If you can master assembling a bicycle on Christmas Eve, then you'll probably be able to assemble your telescope gear. In the following videos, I'll show you some steps I take in assembling my telescope gear. If you're a suburbanite, you'll likely need to travel to dark sites. First thing you'll need is a tarp. Assemble all of your gear on top of the tarp. The tarp helps reduce dust and dirt that may fly around your gear. Dust and dirt are your optics' worst enemies. If you're under the sun, it's more comfortable to bring a quick shade pop-up. I've set up with and without the quick shade. Believe me, a few degrees cooler really helps on warmer days. Two sticks and a compass. Yep, that's how I line my tripod. If you use a magnetic compass, you'll need to be aware of magnetic declination. True north isn't the same as magnetic north, and magnetic north changes from location to location. A good website to visit is magnetic-declination.com. Here you can find the magnetic declination for your location. If you have a smartphone, you can try a free compass app called Compass from catch.com. This little app has a true north feature that will automatically dial in true north. Okay, we've covered the compass. Let's get back to the two sticks. Take one of the sticks and align it perpendicular to true north. Then make a right angle with the other stick. Use the front leading stick to align your front tripod legs. This will align your tripod close to the true north. Next step is to install the mount head. An old milk crate is a sturdy case to store my mount head. You'll want to protect the mount head from damage anytime you travel. Later on, I'll show you how you can use the milk crate for another purpose. It's important to level your tripod. Most mounts have a level bubble. Lower the tripod leg closest to the bubble until it's perfectly centered. Take your time and be sure it's level. The tripod is the foundation for a good star alignment. Another note, I use Orion rock stable pads to help absorb vibrations and keep the tripod legs from sinking in the soft soil. Now we need to release the counterweight bar by releasing the latch and retightening. Remove the toe stopper at the end of the counterweight shaft. Then install the counterweights and replace the toe stopper. It's important to install the counterweights first on your mount head. The reason you do this is to avoid your telescope assembly from crashing into the tripod legs. This wraps up part one. Next video, we'll dive into power supplies and telescope assemblies. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.